my friends, Paul here in the RoJoBe Music Workshop, and welcome to part two of the new, another cigar box guitar build project. Okay, so first of all, apologies for the abrupt ending of the first video. I wasn't keeping an eye on the time, and I was showing you at the end of that how I'm removing these frets. So just in case you did miss any of that, I've left a couple of the frets still to do. So let me just zoom in first. Okay, let me just move that up a bit. There we go, like that. Okay, so I was using these fret pullers, my new ones, but to be honest, the width across here is a little bit big because this is a radiused fretboard. So I've switched back to my old ones, which, you know, always did work perfectly well, and they're much better for this job. So got my paintbrush, just water. So just brush a little bit of water, mildly soapy water, either side of the fret. Let that soak in for a minute. Can I zoom in a bit more? I don't want it to go out of focus. Yeah, we're good. Okay. So, I get the fret end pullers just located underneath. Give it a little bit of a wiggle to start to loosen it up. Then should start to, the jaws of the fret pullers should just start to ease underneath the frets as it's coming up, which it's now doing. As I said, these smaller ones are much better for the radius fretboards and frets because it's just easier to get under there with a narrower head. Okay, that one's come out fine. Last one. Dab more water on that one just to be safe. It's dried out a bit. Okay, it's coming now. So, I have to say that all of those frets came out really nicely, far too easy to be honest. And so that's now all of the frets out, every single one, and there is basically no tear out at all on that wood, which is fantastic. So, I'm going to keep these frets in a little baggie. Obviously they're brand spanking new, never used, and they will do for another project, or, you know, a refret or something like that. Okay, so next job is to, I've already cut out the headstock template. I'm just going to zoom out a little bit, so focusing. Okay, so I've already cut out the headstock template, and I made sure I went carefully around the edge, around the line of it, because I want to make sure that I've got a good edge to cut up to. And I've also, off camera, I don't know if you can see it, but I've made some pencil marks so that I know that this is going to be in the centre. So I've made two pencil marks here and here, and also on the fretboard here and here. And also at the bottom end of the fretboard, I've figured out what kind of taper I want, and it's not much. It's a 5mm taper from top to bottom, which is not much, but that's how it's going to match the headstock and the nut, and also the bridge and saddles. So I did want a bit of a taper. But not too much, and I've you know worked it out and got where I need to be. So I'm going to stick the template onto the headstock. You can see just how much excess woods there's going to be. Look, insane. But that's good because I'll use that wood for building up the neck heel. Okay, so I'm going to stick it on with a glue stick. Obviously, I don't want it to move around, but I don't want it to be, you know, stuck like cement, because obviously it will need to come off again as well. So, can I turn that round a bit and see what I'm doing? Not really. Okay. So, all I'm going to be doing is lining up with these pencil marks and up against the end of the fretboard and making sure it's straight, and then just stick down. So I'm not going to use too much of this, just a bit around the edge just to hold it down. Don't need too much. Ugh, gooey, messy, sticky stuff. Just make sure I've got all of the edge covered with glue. Okay, so I've got to make sure I get this lined up perfectly, because once it's stuck down, it won't come back off easily. Okay. Check that for alignment. Go a little bit over. Okay, I'm quite happy with that. So that's it, stuck down onto the headstock. Let me just double check for alignment. It does look good. Just as well, because it ain't coming off now. Okay, that's fine. I'm quite happy with that. So now I'm going to, I'll just zoom you out a bit, I'm going to draw the lines down the fretboard for the actual width. So, let me just... but it's not that stable, so just make sure I get that lined up first. Okay, looks pretty good. Okay, I'm going to go with that. Not sure how well this is going to show up on this, actually. Fine, and the other side. Okay, let's go with that. Okay. So, that's the lines drawn on the fretboard. You can barely see them, but yeah, I think you see it quite well like that. So, I haven't gone with the same taper as the fretboard itself, but I have, as I said, I've calculated it and just made sure that I'm happy with the taper. And that looks pretty good. So it now I've got the template on there, I've got the lines drawn on the fretboard. That's where I'm going to be cutting it, on the on the bandsaw. Now, first of all, I'm just going to take that nut out. I may or may not use this nut because it's the right, you know, profile and shape and everything, but I'm pretty sure that's plastic. Yeah, it's plastic. So, I don't know. Do I have a bone blank that's going to work with that? I don't really want to use plastic. It's not even a high grade of plastic. It's soft. Okay. Let's see what I've got. I do still have quite a lot of the bone blanks, but they're much thicker than this, and I don't really feel much like cutting one down. But what I have got here, which one was it? Is that one? Yeah. This one, which is actually a saddle from a ukulele. And I'm not sure if that's bone or not, but it's very unflexible. So if it is a plastic one, it's a high quality one. Now let me just see if that will fit in the slot. Oh, it's almost perfect. I mean, it goes in there, but it does wiggle about slightly. Can I get away with that? I think I could actually. yeah, I might well go with that then. Height wise, obviously, it's way too high. I'll need to cut it down a bit. And the other thing as well is the original nut is radiused. This one is not. This one's straight. So I don't know. I'm undecided on that at the moment. I might just use the original saddle and just cut it down because the radius is already there. It's the right fit. Yeah, it might be all right. It might be all right. But if I'm not happy with it, then I've got this as an alternative. The only downside is that obviously I'd have to put the radius in it and then reshape the top and then cut the slots and blah, blah, blah. So what to do? Because, you know, even if I use the original nut, once I've cut it down to length, I'll have to redo the slots again as well. Anyway, I can't decide at this stage. That's obviously not anything I need to worry about right now. So I won't. okay, so the next stage, as I said, is to actually cut this this neck and fretboard down to width, down to the right width. I am a bit worried about doing this, because if it goes wrong, I'll have to start all over again, and I don't have another neck blank. I'd have to buy another one. It should be okay. I'm sure that it's going to be fine. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to keep this number part two short, so I'm going to end it here. Then I'm going to get the bandsaw set up and the camera set up next to the bandsaw, and we will start making some sawdust. So I'd like to thank you all for watching. If you're enjoying these videos, please subscribe if you haven't already. Hit the notification bell. Give us a thumbs up and a comment. Share with your friends, colleagues, and relatives. And we will see you in the next one. Peace out.